These developments are run by the St. Louis Housing Authority. This is a far cry from the crowded, collapsing tenements that many of these people have known. Here in bright new buildings with spacious grounds, they can live. Live with indoor plumbing, electric lights, fresh plastered walls, and the rest of the conveniences that are expected in the 20th century.
Our film is about the changing American city in the post-war years, and so it's filtered through what became a notorious public housing project in St. Louis. St. Louis changed quite a bit. Its population declined drastically. Deindustrialization, all the major factors that led to the decline of the post-war American city are present in Pruitt-Igoe.
Pruitt-Igoe project in St. Louis is a casebook example.
And when many people discuss Pruitt-Igoe, they often discuss it in terms of an architectural failure, as something that failed because of the style of architecture that it was built in. Architects have often discussed Pruitt-Igoe in this way to kind of create this sense of Pruitt-Igoe as this iconic place, as something that really can be identified with the modern movement. And so if this fails, then the modern movement of architecture failed as a whole.
It was a powerful story with a dramatic end. The footage was replayed again and again. One image seemed to sum up the infamy. It circulated worldwide. It was reprinted next to photos from earlier years and suggested a simple question. What caused the failure? The Pruitt-Igoe myth begins here.
And so that's the initial myth, but we kind of broadened it in our analysis. And you know, we're also talking about how public housing is often viewed as a failure because it is public housing, because it's federal housing. People tend to blame the government. Or people tend to look at Pruitt-Igoe as a failure because of the residents. They say that the residents tore up this public housing project. And so these are the kind of like general myths that we're dealing with in the film, really trying to eliminate the scapegoats that have often plagued discussion of Pruitt-Igoe and public housing in general.
I know a lot of bad things came out of Pruitt-Igoe. I know they did. But I don't think they outweigh the good. I really, really don't.
We wanted to keep this story, one, about the experience in the projects themselves. And so from the residents' perspective is what we're really focusing on. You know, those are the stories that whenever you have this kind of iconic symbol, those tend to get lost. And so bringing those stories to screen and allowing and recording the residents speaking of those moments, it was really eye-opening to me.
Plenty of green grass, trees, shrubbery, and all the works.
What happened?
Well, one day we woke up and it was all gone.
In the middle 50s, St. Louis thought it had solved its low-cost housing needs, but instead a monster was created.
But things changed quickly. As problems mounted, the decline was steep. Those who could move out did.
12,000 people were originally...
Rather than relying on archival footage simply for its journalistic merits, you know, presenting like a documentary, the implosion, or news reports from the day, now all of a sudden we had documentary footage that could give a kind of texture to life in the projects. And that was something that opened up in a completely new artistic avenue for me. I don't know if St. Louis has really changed that much from the days of Pruitt-Igoe, unfortunately. In St. Louis, we were hoping that we would see an increase in the population. But in fact, the recent census figures showed that we actually went down 10% again. So this entire process is one that's continuing. Yes, there is gentrification within the city, certain parts of the city, but overall the city is still losing population. When you're thinking about public housing, you really need to put it in its, I think people need to put it in its broader context in discussions of public housing. People often tend to separate Pruitt-Igoe or public housing in general from the larger urban context, the larger shifts in the American city that were taking place in these years. That's what we were trying to get at with this film, was getting away from trying to place blame on one particular thing, you know, looking at it in its much broader context.